Hello and welcome to this tutorial on the SpaceClaim user interface. So as with most Windows applications, we have the tool ribbon at the top, which contains all the tools we might use while we're creating our model. There's also a number of other tabs up here. We start with the design tab, and there's also, of course, the file tab where we can open, load, save files, etc. We can also change the options here. If we click on, go down to here in SpaceClaim options. This will be important when you want to change options like, for example, the units that you want to use, either metric or imperial, and the type of specific type of unit you want to use. Now there's a number of other tabs besides the design tab. There's the insert tab and the a number of other ones that are included with the base version of SpaceClaim. Some of them may not be available in your version of SpaceClaim. Many of them are available as additional add-ons, such as the sheet metal tab, the momentum tab, etc. Those are not included in the base version of SpaceClaim. Now, in addition to the toolbar up here, we also have the structure tree. Not much to see here right now. As we build our models or load other models in, this structure tree will populate with various objects that we can manipulate and reorganize if we wish in a hierarchical view. We also have, right now this is set to options. We have the options panel and a properties panel, which will show the properties of selected objects. Options will provide different options depending on what tool is selected. In this case, we have the select tool selected, so it allows you to change things like snap to grid, snap to angle, etc. Then down at the bottom here, we have the status bar, which shows us information such as the position on the screen. So you'll see if I, as I move my mouse around the design window, the various locations, the display here changes to show the coordinates, the XY coordinates of that arrow. There's a number of other things down here. There's tools for changing the selection mode. There's also tools for moving around the view in various ways. Many of these tools are available as keyboard shortcuts, which is preferable to having to go down here and click on them, but that option is available. You'll also see this here, you'll often see warnings. You might see a red stop sign to indicate that there's an operation underway that you can stop, etc. And of course, the main part of the window is the design window, where you have the grid. Currently, nothing is showing on it other than the axis. But as we build our models, of course, we're going to see the models represented here in this view, which can be changed in various ways using this widget down in the corner. You'll see as I click on the X and the various axes, it reorients the window to show from those various views, and so on and so forth. Okay, so I hope that was a useful overview of the user interface. In the next set of tutorials, we will start to create something and actually start making a model. So thank you very much for watching.